Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. So today we're doing a first impressions video as well as a review of standard notes. We're going to be diving into the application about how to use it, how it's sort of grown and expanded, and we're also going to be diving into a full demonstration of how to use it as well as pricing and information like that. I'm really excited because it's a good Evernote alternative, although it does still have lots to learn. Anyway guys, let's dive into standard notes today. Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. So we are reviewing standard notes today and I have it on Mac today. Now standard notes is available on Mac, Windows, Linux, also iOS and Android and web, which makes it a pretty accessible note-taking application. And if I'm brutally honest, I probably only discovered this application about 2 or 3 months ago. It's been on my radar because a lot of people go, there's no resources about standard notes out there. How can we understand it? How can we know about it? And of course, I wanted to do a feature on it naturally. So guys, this video will demonstrate some of the features and functions of it, as well as outline some of the pricing information that you need to know, and also give you as much information as possible about this application that has been provided. Now, I was actually pretty impressed by the application, if I'm honest. The branding, the efforts that they've put into designing it, as well as making it sort of this community-led application, really does, you know, it's very credible and it is giving me a good impression so far. Now, the application is free. It does have a premium version, which we'll be diving into near the end of this video. So if you understand it, if you're like, I already understand standard notes, why should I upgrade? Then skip to the end of this video. But again, this application is open source, so it's really designed for people to sort of take it apart too. So you can see here, this is the standard notes on Mac. I will be demoing on iOS and sort of sharing some of the differences. They look sort of similar. On this left-hand panel, you have tags, so you can create any tags that you like. So any tags you like, thinking of some tags. let's say shopping list or something super duper simple. And if I press enter, it will create I created a new note. And you can obviously start going there. So I actually need to buy some minstrels because I just ate some minstrels from the fridge. Don't tell my wife. you can see here that it's created them on this left-hand panel. You have the notes list in the center, which is searchable, as well as the ability to create new notes there. Now, if I wanted to delete an item, I would go to options, delete here. And that's how you delete an item. So as you can imagine, once you're inside of the note, you can actually access options, which we just did. You have the ability to pin notes, archive them, actually lock them, which we'll be talking about the security side of stuff in a bit, as well as delete them, change the global font as well, and there's margin restrictions, which is helpful. Now the editor, you're using the plain editor, which is the most simplest editor. There's a lot that you can unlock in Pro, which we'll be talking about nearer the end. Actions, you can download Actions 2, which is another extension, which leads you to that sort of the premium. Again, I would say this application is free in its basic format. You can only pretty much just add notes as they are. Now, you've also got session history. So you can see here that I've got 8 revisions already and you can move back to them too. And you can restore as copy, which is quite a nice addition. So in case you're going there. Now, here are some ones I created earlier. I started taking some notes on lessons that I've been learning from Make Time. As you can see the session history, again, has been adapted. I wrote this one on iPhone. It seems to have transferred pretty well. And you can refresh down at the bottom so that it syncs with all of that. And the great thing is, obviously, you've got really dead simple notes. There's not really much more than that you can do on the freemium version. But the good thing is, the sort of thing that they shout most about is this encryption. So it has end-to-end encryption, which you can set as on. So for example, here you see 6 out of 6 notes are in tags and tags are encrypted. End-to-end encryption is enabled. Your data is encrypted before syncing to your private account. So you do have a private account. You can add a password lock as well, and you can download and import from backups too. So again, it's quite a secure application. That's what it marks itself at. But it does provide a pretty simple experience. Now, as you can see here, everything syncs pretty well, everything is mainly unlocked and thing, and that's why we'll be doing a standard notes extension or pro function that I'll talk about. Again, what I want to do just to round this feature off is really talk about the premium experience. So you can see here that Standard Notes does have a premium version, or what it's called is extended version. It has 27 extensions and counting, and it does unlock a lot of bonus experiences. So you can see here that safeguarding your files. So for example, you can get unlimited file attachments encrypted, which is very helpful. So you can upload directly from Dropbox, Google Drive, or web DAV servers. Helpful. You can also get a whole host of multi-editor productivity, so you can get rich text, markdown, HTML, and tons more, which we'll be talking about in a minute. You've got data care as well, so cloud backups daily, and you can even do a backup of all of your data to Dropbox, Google Drive, and OneDrive. Infinite undo, so you can undo and actually go to loads of revisions. So it looks like that was restricted in the initial edition. The security, so you've got two-step authentication, which is accessible there. So imagine this, you've got your encrypted data, you've got your passcode protection or lock, and you've got your two-step authentication. So that's mad. No one's going to be able to get in. work through the night, you have the dark modes available too. And in the freemium package, in the standard package they call, you've got end-to-end private encryption, unlimited notes, sync to all your devices, unlimited devices, and web and offline access. So you're really getting almost like simple notes for free, just even cleaner and more privatized. So you can see here that there's different plans here. So you've got the one monthly plan, which is $9.99 per month. Again, if you're paying for that and you understand what we're going to be talking about in a minute, it's going to be, you know, that's the full price. You know, that's $120 a year. It's a big investment, double what Newton was. You've got a 5-year plan, which is $2.48, and that's a $149 billed every 5 years, which is something that NordVPN do as well, and just to be aware of them. 1 year plan is $4.17, so that's a total of $50 per year. So they're really pushing you to invest in that bigger price around here. So and they do state a lot about the sustainability of the efforts. So they're actually resources, revenue is solely from the customer so far, and they don't have any advertisers or venture capitalists, so they don't have that effort to raise. They do have a 30-day guarantee on the extended package, so if you don't like it, you can return it. Now, these are some of the editors you get inside of the experience. This is for desktop, web, and mobile. You get advanced markdown, simple markdown, plus editor, fancy markdown editor, minimal editor, code editor, simple task editor, and Vim editor. I didn't even know Vim editor existed. You've also got components as well, so you can have a quick tags area so you can quickly access them, and that supports keyboard shortcuts and folders. An action bar, giving you an outline of the useful utility, how many words you've typed in, and being able to duplicate efforts too. A GitHub push, folders as well for your tags, so you can nest different things under folders. You've got themes as well, focused, midnight, Futura, solarized, dynamic, and no distraction mode. And you can try these all if you want to, just by pressing the try it button. You've also have data care, file safe, Dropbox sync, Google Drive sync, OneDrive sync, daily email backup too, and two-step authentication of where there's note history, so you can restore from previous editions. You also have actions, so you can publish to your blog from standard notes. So there is quite a lot of value in the experience. Now, the thing that they sell themselves as is mainly the privacy side of stuff. They have end-to-end encryption, they have secure networks, and they do have a whole host of list of, well, a list of things that they outline here. But again, they don't have any ads or tracking technologies inside that. They have respectful analytics. But the one thing I haven't seen on their blog is, like, sometimes companies have like a privacy or terms document for their users. Whereas this is more of a manifesto. They really should have that. I don't know. Maybe I'm completely missing it. Maybe it's in the FAQ page or something, but I can't find it. Let me know in the comments if I missed it. But again, this is something that they need to definitely consider. Anyway, guys, I want to take you through the iOS application, and then we'll round off everything. So guys, as you can imagine, they have an iOS application. As you can see in this left-hand side, it looks more like a calendar application, which is quite exciting. So when you open up your Standard Notes account, you are asked to open it with fingerprint, which is quite nice. It syncs automatically. As you've seen, it just syncs the additions there that we made inside of the likes of the Mac application. And as you can see here, you've got notes, you've got search. It's very simple. As you can see, there's no text formatting. There's no option to text format. You can manage a document or a note, unpin it, lock it, do what you want with it. And you can get web editors too. So once you install them, it does make it more accessible. You can filter them with date added or it tags, for example, if you wanted to, and create new tags from there. Now your account is accessible here and you can use the fingerprint sensor, as well as it gives you all the information about encryption. It's AES 256, which I believe is bank grade security encryption. And also you've got your account keys. The one thing it does say is when you're creating your account, there's no forget password function. So if you forget your password, you have to recreate your account. And that's something that you should be aware of. Again, this application is available on Android as well as web, Linux, Windows and Mac. So do try it out there. So guys, just to round things off with Standard Notes, I'm impressed by the application. I'm impressed by the design of the application, the encryption level, and also everything like that. What I would say is the feedback has been good so far. It's got a solid 4.7 on iOS. That's 50 ratings. And there is a Slack community, which I messaged. They seem really friendly. And there is a Reddit community too, which I'm sure I'll be interacting with. I'll be doing an extended feature, so please do not take this as it is. Of course, there is a premium experience. And this is very much a first impressions feature, but I will be extending my sort of feature on this. I'm very impressed by the cross-platform function. Functionality of it. It's simple, but it really does work. And if it has the privacy experience that it does state, and that's what it sort of promotes itself as, that's fantastic. And it's definitely something that I know a lot of people that are worried about Google and things like that, and even Evernote will be sort of moving towards. Anyway, guys, big thanks for stopping by today. I hope you enjoyed this feature. Let me know with a like if you enjoyed it, and please comment below with your thoughts on Standard Notes. Without any further ado, guys, I'll see you guys in a future feature. Cheers.